And Jordan Authority, what is going on? My name is Kevin, aka The Tech Ninja, and today I'm doing a comparison between the Nexus 7 2012 and the Nexus 7 2013 edition. Let's get going. In the summer of 2012, Asus and Google teamed up to release the Nexus 7, a 7-inch pure Android tablet starting at $200. And it was to redefine how much quality manufacturers will be able to pack into an economical, pure Google device. The original Nexus 7 proved to be very popular with tablet users, and it gained so much worldwide press attention that non-Android users became curious. Google had a new ambassador on their hands, one that would introduce millions to the Android ecosystem. In a somewhat expected upgrade a year later, Google has released the Nexus 7 2013 edition. Featuring substantial upgrades, the new Nexus 7 2013 packs a substantially better display, much better performance, and it's slimmer than the original too. And with retailers gearing up for the holiday season, many among us want to know, what are the primary differences between the two? How do they stack up against one another? Let's get on in and find out. At the time of its original release, the 2012 Nexus 7 was considered one of the best tablets on the market, sitting in at a svelte 0.41 inches and barely moving the scales at 12 ounces. It redefined what tablet computing could be for people. Looking at the Nexus 7 2013 edition's design, Google and Asus have worked to make it both slimmer and lighter, which is quite an achievement. The Asus was able to cut the thickness down by nearly a whole tenth of an inch, coming in at a thin 0.34 inches. The new Nexus 7 feels amazing in the hand and is noticeably lighter than the older Nexus 7. How much lighter, you might ask? Asus and Google didn't let us down in that department either. It comes in at 10.55 ounces, down from 340 grams to a delicate 290 grams. This makes it one of the lightest tablets going, and it's a delight to hold, and it doesn't burden the users like some other heavier tablets do. iPad. The 2012 Nexus uses a rubber backing that is easy to grip and yet is also very pleasing to the eye. The Nexus logo towards the middle back of the device blends into the design of the backing, and so does the Asus logo near the bottom. And the speaker grille is located just below that. The bezels are a dull chrome color with the power button and volume rocker on the side of the device. For the older Nexus 7, the only camera on the device is located on the front, and it's for video chats and hangouts, and of course, selfies. And the USB port is located at the bottom of the device. The 2013 Nexus device changes the design material completely. This time, a soft rubber coating encases the whole tablet. The speaker grills are sleek and they blend in to the design of the device. They are located towards the bottom and also towards the top of the device. That's right, true stereo sound. In terms of button placement, the power button and volume rockers are in the same locations. The 2012 Nexus 7 features a 1280 by 800 7-inch IPS display. It offers great color reproduction and is capable of a modest 216 pixels per inch. The 2013 Nexus 7 has received a significant bump in the display department, with its new, gorgeous 1920 by 1200 7-inch IPS display, packing a whopping 323 pixels per inch. The new Nexus 7 features the sharpest, densest display of any tablet in the world. When compared side by side with its predecessor, the Nexus 2013 display really makes the original Nexus 7 screen look dated. The colors pop, darks look excellent, and the white balance seems to be near perfect. The high PPI really allows the text to pop out at you, and its sharpness is unmatched. The higher resolutions allows you to comfortably watch a 1080p movie without missing much of the picture due to scaling. And I would honestly put it up there, one of the best on any tablet to date. The Nexus 7 2012 was the first device to feature the NVIDIA Tegra 3 SoC, packing a quad-core 1200 MHz ARM Cortex A9 processor. It also features NVIDIA Tegra graphics with ULP, which is short for ultra low power. GeForce 12-core GPU clocked at 416 Hz, and you'll be able to find it in 8GB and 16GB flavors. The Nexus 7 2013 edition has received a change of processors and GPU, using the Qualcomm this time around. It's officially said that the Nexus 7 2013 uses a Snapdragon S4 Pro, but in reality, it's like a lower spec Snapdragon 600 The SoC itself is a quad core running up to 1500 megahertz. It also features the powerful Adreno 320 processor for graphics. When compared with the original Nexus 7 2012, it packs double the RAM at 2 GB, and onboard storage options include 16 GB and 32 GB. The sole camera on the 2012 edition was a bit of a disappointment, coming in at a paltry 1.2 megapixels. Google really wanted this to be a video chat only camera and opted not to include a camera app out of the box. Google heard the complaints of many users and decided to put in two cameras on its successor, the Nexus 7 2013 edition. The front-facing camera appears to be similar on paper as the 1.2 megapixel camera, but the back camera is a 5 megapixel autofocus enabled camera. Although it may not take stunning shots, it's still a suitable replacement if you don't have any other cameras on hand. Also, for those of you that want a fast mobile data experience, the Nexus 2012 has the options for Wi-Fi and 3G, while the Nexus 7 2013 edition has Wi-Fi or LTE connectivity. Both devices are up to date with the latest Android OS. The newer Nexus, which has the faster and newer Snapdragon processor, tends to load applications just a tad bit faster, and the overall performance is just smoother, and that's to be expected. The 2 GB of RAM really kick into play when applications are installing or an update is occurring in the background. And the Nexus 2012 really suffers from that lag when it's occurring. When running a series of benchmarks on the Nexus 7, it shows significant gains in each test. Although benchmarks are not the end-all be-all, it's still good to see how much faster it really is. When using both devices in day-to-day activity, the Nexus 2013 was faster in virtually all ways. And once again, the speed differences are not in which will you feel your Nexus 2012 is unusable, but if you compare them side by side, it's very noticeable. Rebooting the device, you will notice a 5 to 8 second difference. And also when loading a high-end game like Grand Theft Auto, the load times are almost cut in half. And also the game runs in a smooth fashion. It's not just one spec of the Nexus 7 2013 that's causing the speed differences. It's more of a sum of its total parts. Overall, if you own the 2012 Nexus 7, getting the 2013 will be a significant upgrade. The main question is, are you happy with your current performance? If so, then waiting until 2014 or even later may work best for you. It seems that Google has the business model to release a refresh every year, so waiting every other year would be a method that many will follow, and it may be the best idea. And if you like what you see here, go ahead and push on the like button right below. And if you're not subscribed for some odd reason, go ahead and subscribe to our channel directly. And once again, my name is Kevin, aka The Tech Ninja. You can find me on YouTube and on Google Plus. And we are Android Authority, your source for all things Android. Peace.